Except the club today just put out a statement regarding your future with the speculation time with Melbourne Heart. What moved you to put out that statement today?
No, we are speaking and we don't want to any confusion with our fans that are supporting the team a lot. And I think that if we don't have anything, or in this case, I don't have anything with any club, and I want to stay here, and the club want that I stay, it's better to clarify, and everybody knows that tomorrow that is an important game. I don't want that people be confused, and I am 100% here, and I want the best for the club, and the best for me is stay here, and just this, that everybody knows that my commitment with the team is 100%, and what appear in the media is not true, and it's important that the people know, because in the end can create confusion, and we want that everybody tomorrow come here with the power for to help us in this important game that we play here at home.
So you mentioned an extension. Are you in any hurry to get an extension here?
No, it's not in a hurry. We are in speaking, because what we want to do is a long-term project. It's something that we spoke in the beginning of the season, but in that moment the club decided that that this was not the moment. Now for me it's also not the moment, in terms that I want to be concentrated 100% in the games, and not just me and the players and everybody, but when we finish the season I think that we can arrive to this agreement and we can sign for an extension.
Do you take it as a compliment that you're linked to other clubs after your performance so far at Adelaide United?
I don't understand the question.
A compliment, like a pat on the back, a positive that you're getting linked to other clubs?
I think that always is positive when Adelaide thinks that that speak about the work that you are doing. In this case, I don't want to speak about my person. For me, it's the team. Okay, in the end, I am a player. Who are playing are the players. And what I am more satisfied is that they believe in the project and they are running and they are doing everything with a lot of power. And it's good that the people speak, but one thing is they speak and the other is that can be an offer from one club or another club. This is not true. And what we want now is to be strong and to be competitive and to be concentrated in these two games and to try to get the final, because it's not to do it, we need one more point, and after that play the finals with the best way that we can and to try to arrive in the high position that we can. It's just this, and to finish the season in the best way and bring this to the people that is supporting us all the year, and I hope and I wish that next season will be better for us, because we will start with more power and we can align the team with some movements, and in that moment we will be more competitive.
Just to clarify, you said you were made an offer by the Heart, but were you sounded out about your future at all?
I don't understand.
Well, you mentioned before the report was inaccurate that you weren't made an offer by the Melbourne Heart, but did they sound you out about your interest at all?
No. Just what is true is that I know very well the people in Manchester City. This is true. I work with them for 7 years. The people that I have very close relationship is the football director of Manchester City. He's Chicky Begiristain. He and me works together for a few years. And when they come to here to Australia, he called me, and we spoke about football and about this, and we work together in Barcelona. But one thing is this, and the other thing is that I can have an offer. For me, there are one important thing that for this also today we put in the website, is because tomorrow is the game. For me, the coach is doing very well. He just signed for 3 years extension, and I think that is we need to respect a lot this. And when one thing come and is not true, just for the respect to the coach and the work that they are doing, that is very good, we say this, and this is important. Tomorrow I will speak with him and I will explain, and also yesterday I spoke with the football director in Manchester City for to explain also that this is something that I don't know why I paid, because it's not true, because in the end, they are my friends, and I want that they have very clear that in any moment I speak, or my agent, or the club, and say something about this.
Talked about playing finals, need that extra point. Where do you think you deserve to finish? Do you think you're capable of finishing in the top two?
Of course, if you finish in top two, first one, you have the passport for to play the next IFC. That this is a big deal for us. Finish the top two, make that you play at home. And this is very important. But what I want is to go game by game, because we can finish top two, but if we lose two games and the other teams win, we can don't be in the finals. The most important is tomorrow. Tomorrow is a big game. Melbourne Heart is doing very well. They are playing a good football. And today is what I saw. I say to my players, we check the last games that they play. They are doing so well. And tomorrow will be a big game. I invite to the people that come tomorrow, because it's the most important game for us, to support to us. And tomorrow we will fight and we'll line every single ball for to try to win. And if we win, next week another step. And after that, we are in top, in second position, perfect. We are in third, we are in fourth. Doesn't matter. This year, we don't change what we say in the beginning. The important is to build the project, and now we are in the first step, and just this.
Sergio, are you fit?
Yeah, I'm okay. I am training good this week, and I am ready to play tomorrow.
Start?
I don't know. The coach decided. I don't know.
So what was the actual problem?
Sorry?
What was the problem?
In my hamstring, in one action during the game against Sydney, during the second half. But during the week with the physios, they are working very good with me. And now I am ready I am ready to play tomorrow.
It took you a little while to get used to maybe the physical side of the A-League. You think you've settled in a little bit more as the season progressed?
I don't understand.
In the beginning, maybe you took a little while to get used to maybe the A-League, the physical aspect of the game. Are you more or less used to how it is?
I don't know. During the pre-season, we work a lot for to fit good during the season, and the team I think is playing good. The fit of the team is very good, and the most important that is the way that we are playing is good. We are enjoying the supporters are enjoying with us, and I think this is the most important.
So, what really worries you about Melbourne Heart?
A lot of things. First one, that that my players don't think that is an easy game. This is something that today we spoke, because they are doing really well the last games. And after, the way that they are playing, they know what they do. They lose the last two games, but they play against top teams, Brisbane and Central Coast. And but I saw the last 5-6 games, and they start to have movements that they are doing every single game. When they do this, is because they know very well what they need to do, and what we need to do is to play our way and to try that they don't feel comfortable here in our home. But it's a difficult game. It's not easy.
So the start will be very crucial to get on top early.
Yeah, of course. If we want to be on top, in top two, we need to win tomorrow. If not, we cannot be there. And but the players know we work hard. Everybody's concentrate. I think that will be a nice game, a nice football game.
If you finish in the four, would you like to play Adelaide Oval?
The first final, no?
The second, would you like to play Adelaide Oval?
I don't see the stadium yet, but it's something that the club need to decide. If the club need decide this, we will check, we will see, and if everybody's agree, it's not my decision.
Well, I think the FFA actually calls it, whether you play them or not.
Yeah.
It's not up to any club, it's up to FFA.
This, I don't know. I'm new in this. If the FFA say this, we need to play this, no objection. In the end, it's a field, and we need to play. If I can decide, depending what is the field, in which condition is the grass, because here the grass is very good, and for us, for our style, I like a lot. But in the end, if the FFA decide, whatever we need to play, we will play.
Did you go watch the showdown the other day with Crows and obviously what Adelaide, you saw the atmosphere of the stadium?
Yeah, I saw that, not the game because we was in New Zealand, but I saw the highlights and it was amazing. But we need to think that maybe in our football, not this kind of people, this number of people is coming, and the stadium is very, very big, and maybe we don't make this full, and sometimes it's better 16,000 stadium full and everybody pressing that 50,000 with 25, because you feel that it's empty. I like this in Hong Kong, when we have Hong Kong Stadium, 47,000, or we have Mongkok, that is 12,000, and I like to play in Mongkok because come 10,000, 8,000 is full, and you feel this, and I like more like this.
So you prefer to stay here?
If it's not our decision,
but
yeah, here's our home. We play every single game, but this is normal because the players know this stadium. We know this stadium. We feel comfortable here. In the end, it's our home. We play always here. To change is to play in a different way, but in the end, we will adapt with the FFA or the club or whatever decide. It's our job to go and to play in the place that the people say that we need to play. But here the grass is perfect.
That's it.
Thank you.